Hi folks, Nick Arneson here, outreach specialist for the UW Cropping Systems Weed Science Program with Dr. Rodrigo Worley. And I'm excited to share with you just a brief update on one of our studies that we've collaborated with Dr. Sean Conley and Dr. Damon Smith in the Departments of Agronomy and Plant Pathology. In this project, we're looking at cereal rye in non-GMO soybeans. So I just want to thank our sponsors and the staff and students in our program and Dr. Conley and Dr. Smith's programs for assisting in this trial and the data collection that's allowed me to give this opportunity to talk about this project today. So as I mentioned, we're looking at food grade non-GMO soybeans, and there are two objectives to this research. So one of the big things our program's trying to understand is how does this cereal rye cover crop interact with the fate of soil-applied residual pre-emergent herbicides. So we're looking at termination timings of that cover crop and how it impacts that fate of those herbicides. And then additionally, of course, what we're interested in is what's the impact of the termination timings of that cereal rye on just general soybean yield. And in this particular scenario, we're looking at non-GMO food grade soybeans. And here you can see a photo from one of our studies of a rye planting into some standing cereal rye. So here's an overview of our experiment, and if you have the opportunity to pause this video, I encourage you to do so, take a deeper look at our experimental background. I'm just gonna go rather quickly here. 2x2x3 factorials, so we've got two non-GMO food grade soybean varieties, two pre-emergent herbicide programs that are applied at the time of soybean planting. So we have a no pre-emergence program and then a yes pre. That yes pre is a broad XXC at its label rate, which is a premix of two active ingredients, sulfentrazone and S-metolachlor. And then we have our three cereal rye cover crop termination timings. So we've got our early and our at plant. Early was done 8 days before planting, and at plant at the time of soybean planting, and both of those terminations were done with glyphosate, which is our typical chemical termination for cereal rye when we're looking at incorporating before our soybean production. Now, when we're talking about non-GMOs, we've got to change things up with our late termination. So this is 14 days after planting. Our non-GMO beans are fully emerged at this time. So we switch to clethodim, a group one, which will kill the rye but not injure the soybeans. So if you take a look here in this table, you can see some of our soil information and then dates for our termination timings and our cereal rye planting and then soybean planting and soybean harvest as well. So first, I just want to take a look at cereal rye biomass production. So I just want to point out this box here shows our early at plant and our late terminology. So 8 days before planting early, 0 DAP at planting, 14 DAP is late. So you'll see that from slide to slide. So keep that as a reference. Here are our termination timings across the bottom. Our cereal rye biomass, you can see 2019, 2020. Typical same trend, kind of what we expected. Longer we let that cereal rye grow, higher amount of biomass accumulated. And this 14 days after planting is where we're seeing this amount of biomass that we would anticipate maybe some abilities to impede some weeds, and there's no weed control element to this study necessarily, but this is something we always want to keep an eye on when we're looking at cereal rye biomass production. Now this photo here is taken in 2020 at the time of our 14 day after planting application, and you can see with our early, not a lot of biomass on the ground, you can't see much. Here at our at planting, you can still see some of that cereal rye biomass. And then if you take a look at that 14 days after, we see a considerable amount of cereal rye biomass and green cereal rye growing alongside our green soybeans. So first, just dive into that soil residual pre-fate and see how the termination timing of cereal rye has impacted it. Again, we've got our termination timings on the bottom here and our herbicides on the vertical axis. We had a termination timing by site year interaction, so we're just looking at these specifically by herbicide, but then also by year within each herbicide. In general, we just had inconsistent results over the 2 years for what we saw. In general, we thought higher biomass cereal rye, more impact on the fate of residual. What we found is that more often than not, we didn't see that type of impact, and we just saw an inconsistent impact on herbicide concentration. Now, if we take a look at 2020 here in the S-metolachlor concentration, we do see with that high amount of biomass, that 14 days after planting, we do see a significant reduction in S-metolachlor concentration compared to that early and at plant termination. But it was just in that 1 year with this particular active ingredient. So it was a drier year in 2020. We had that standing biomass that hung around a little longer that might have impacted that. So we'll be doing more research to try to better understand when and what impacts we're going to anticipate with the cereal rye and pre-emergent herbicide interaction. Now we take a look at yield. And again, I've got the box here telling you what our termination timings are. So if you need for reference for our tables, just want to draw attention again to that graphic I showed earlier about the cereal rye biomass, that trending up, right? Where we see that later termination, higher amount of biomass. Now in 2019, story's good here. We don't see any impact on yield when it comes to regardless of termination timing of cereal rye. So no impact, that's great news. Now we take a look at 2020. And this is, remember I mentioned that cereal rye stuck around for a little bit. You know, we use clethodim. It's a slower moving herbicide, doesn't kill the rye as fast as glyphosate normally does. So this is where we saw an impact. Specifically, we saw at that late termination, we saw a reduction in soybean yield in these non-GMO varieties compared to that early termination. And it's just in this one particular scenario so far, the research that we've done, that we've seen an impact on soybean yield with a late termination. So just a few take-home messages here. I just want to say that in general, our cereal rye termination timing has had inconsistent effects on herbicide fate in the soil. Not only this study, but in other studies that we've conducted, we're starting to see just a variable impacts. In general, we don't see an impact for that cereal rye, but in this particular scenario in 2020, we did see that late termination reduce that S-metolachlor compared to the other terminations. When it comes to soybean yield, these non-GMO varieties, we did not see earlier at soybean plant determination timings have any impact on yield, which is great news. And only in 1 year did we see that later termination, that 2 weeks after planting, reduced soybean yield. And in that particular scenario, you know that clethodim took a while to kill that rye, and we saw just an opportunity there for the soybeans to be competing with the cereal rye, and just stressed out a bit where we start to see some of that impacts on soybean yield. So just on those lines, you know, I think it's important that our program looks at additional chemical options in non-GMO soybeans to look at some other group one herbicides that are available. We know that glyphosate's not available for us in this system, so and we tried clethodim and we were not satisfied with the length of time. We like the biomass production, we like that element for weed suppression, but we don't want to sacrifice soybean yield. So we're going to take a look at some other herbicides and additional research here to come and try to understand what would be a great fit for non-GMO soybean production. So again, I'm Nick Arneson, Outreach Specialist. Here's my information. If you have any questions, please reach out. Stay tuned for more research updates and videos this summer, additional research we're gonna be conducting with cereal rye. We're gonna have a lot of interesting stuff to test this year and excited to get that information out to you. So I hope you enjoy this and the other videos provided by our program, and I look forward to talking to you soon about these research. Thanks.